great tasting food, good company, and that's how I like to roll. It's Done on Fire Season 3, made possible by LICC Jeans, and this time around, I'm at the Kingsbury Hotel, and I'm going to check out UH1 restaurant with one guest who looks simply amazing. She is a silver screen superstar, Urani, on the show with me. It's Done on Fire right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel powered by LICC, and we are at the Kingsbury Hotel, and we're at UH1 restaurant. I just wanted to say it right. I hope I did. Yeah, right? It sounded like the Chinese somewhat restaurant where they serve some brilliant food. And my date for today is a stunning lady, Urani, of course, who has graced the silver screen, many screens in terms of performance, dance, acting, singing, and the list goes on. Thanks for joining me today.
Thank you, Dano, for having me.
All right, so let's start off.
Yes.
You know, I was supposed to act as your boyfriend.
Where was this?
This is what I wanted to tell you. It was back in 2007 when you acted your first teledrama.
Kindurangana.
Yes, where you had the three sisters. You were the second one, right?
Yes.
So this is
news to me.
Ah, there you go. So they were searching for tall, fair people at that time.
It took you like 15 years to tell me that.
Not 15, man.
13 years.
Yeah,
precise.
So what happened was, so I was in the lift, and the director who has come down from India saw me in the lift, and I was not for this because I was working for an English channel at that time. So I went away and they gave word that they wanted to see me. So when I came to meet him at the office that day, he said, "We want you to act as the boyfriend to one of the sisters," and they showed me you, and I said, "Oh, I know her," because she was roommate with one of my friends, and yeah, I've known her before. She was a Vellavatta girl at that time. So, and I was like, "Oh, I know her." And so, of course, I told them that.
Okay.
So they said, "Oh," I said, "I can't speak Sinhala that much." At that time, my language was quite limited. And they said, "No, that's okay. We can work around it." But it was a decision, either I give up my full-time job and take this over or not, because you all were based outstation for
Nigambo,
a period of so many months, and you all got like, yeah. So I still remember, I would have acted as your boyfriend at that time. What a bust I missed.
I know, darling. I know.
Did you get someone good like me to act in that telly with you?
Let me go back and...
No. No.
Well, I'm okay. I mean, I'm happy, I think. I was happy.
I did.
But anyway, back then, Dano was a good looker.
What are you saying back then?
I mean...
I take back the cheer.
Dano,
you
need
back
to...
Then?
You had almost six pack, you remember?
Almost so.
Yeah, almost.
Now also it's there. It's just that I have kept it away because of
and
evil
And I
won't
mention names that you used to date like quite a couple of hotties back then.
Women?
Starting with N.
Ah, yes, back in the day. So,
yeah.
I was very confused, no. All right, so...
Now you're thinking straight.
When the thinking is straight, it's the other way around. Alright, so tell me about your food habits.
Well, I eat clean, Dano.
Yeah.
As you could see.
Yeah.
I don't eat junk, but I honestly don't have cravings.
Do you have like a cheat day at all?
I do.
Okay.
Yeah. Like this morning I had like 2 o'clock in the morning I went and worked like a waffle banana, caramelized banana.
Okay. But mostly you're disciplined. You
very,
try to stick
very,
to...
Yeah.
Is it because of the trade or you have always been this way?
I've always been concerned about my health, how I look, probably because of the industry.
Yeah, and it requires a lot of
It's comparative. Effort. It's getting, it's not like you're getting younger every day, so you need
but
to look after
actually,
yourself.
Actually, is there a size that matters really? Because everyone is showing like bulge, you know, to become stars today.
Is it? Are you referring to the Sri Lankan industry?
Yeah, bulge. That's far from the body.
But at least the younger generation is somewhat better.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
No, I'm talking about the young ones that are coming up now.
Really?
To get their Instagram followers.
I thought they're more healthy.
They're showing bulge, not curves.
Okay, fine. I take that back. But yeah, I think I've always set my eyes on, you know, big things in life. So I always worked... Still working to, towards it. So probably because of that, I'm always concerned about how I look,
So food has always been a very disciplined medium to attend.
Very, very.
Okay, what's your normal diet like throughout the day?
Oh, okay, so right now, I take a lot of, it's more like 80% protein diet. So okay. I have about 10 to 12 egg whites.
Really, in the morning?
No, I try to break it. Yeah, throughout the day. Yeah, so just 6 in the morning and 6 in the night.
Right.
And then I have a little bit of rice if I want to, but I try to stay away from rice because I tend to. And dairy,
no.
Because according to the blood group, it changes, you know, your diet changes.
I know. Dairy is my weak point. You know, I love dairy, but at the same time, it's so bad for you. And it takes like an year to digest, I think.
So lots of good fat, avocados, curd.
Okay.
So
you've done your research as to what actually suits
what
you.
What works for me.
Right. And you're also a gym girl, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah. I see you working out.
Yes.
When I'm not
hard.
Working out.
Working hard.
Yeah. So you, so your fitness also goes hand in hand with it.
Very, yes.
All right. So today is going to be a cheat day, right? This show, it's all about eating.
Yeah, that's it.
So, yeah, the one needs some panna colada and be happy with that here today.
I can't say no to Danu.
There you go, yeah. That's the whole point. All right, so tell me about your time growing up. What was your favorite meal?
Rice and curry.
Okay, that was always. What was your favorite combination to go with it?
I was in the hostel.
Okay.
So like being a hosteler, every Thursdays we used to get yellow rice, dal, chicken, papadang and butter mochi.
Okay.
So that was like, wow.
Yeah.
That was like the wow dish. Like we would just count it, like wait till Thursday just to have yellow rice, dal,
But that was what will just give you the kick for the week.
So
my mom lived in the boarding too, and she took an oath saying that, you know, I'm never going to put these kids into the boarding, because back in the days, boardings changed the way it was operated.
Yeah.
And they became much more kind, I will say.
Yeah, but even back then when I used to be in the boarding, rules were strict.
Rules were strict.
And
but
it
food
was like
pleasant,
a curse.
Right?
It was like we were like prisoned in a cage somewhere.
But like every piece of carrot needs to go in.
Yeah. Yes.
We're going to speak about why she ended up in the boarding. That's where the interesting part is. For those who don't know Urani and you have always seen on screen and thought, wow, she's really hot, or she's lucky to, like, you know, be on screen. That's a very deep story to it, and that's why I respect and love this girl a lot. We'll speak more, of course, when we do come back right here on Danu on Fire. This is IT. The show, it's Danu on Fire right here on High TV, made possible by LICC Jeans. Big shout out goes out to the Kingsbury Hotel. We're at Yuichuan restaurant. I might just go blind trying to say it properly. It's like too much of mental pressure that I go through to say it. So in terms of ordering our mains, we did it already because you are on a full meat only.
Yes.
So you have gone for
Salmon sashimi.
Okay, and I've gone for homestyle.
Okay.
Chicken. Chicken. Something.
Okay.
These names are tricky, no? So you come and order the same thing that I have ordered to make life easy. All right. So while we wait for our food, here's a little crunch time. Oh, he's already here. Okay. Here's a little crunch time about what makes Urani who she is. So Urani, she said that, you know, she was in the boarding from the age of 7.
Yes.
The reason is when she was 7, her mom and dad passed away in a car crash. And little you know, this girl was a scholar in school. She got 10 A's for her O-levels and 4 A's for her A-levels. She was actually the bright spark. So how was it growing up for you?
Very difficult.
But you also were very young.
Yeah.
So did a lot of people spoil you and...
No, not really, Danu. My childhood was not an ordinary childhood, what a normal child would have.
Right.
You know, so... I was very disturbed.
Mm.
I was never loved, probably because my grandparents was also struggling at that time.
Right.
So, and of course in the hostel, pretty much to yourself, of course you have your friends.
Yeah.
But I remember, even from a very young age, I wanted that belongingness, I wanted that love, I wanted that attention, I was craving for everything, you know. So when I don't get it, it comes out as arrogance, yeah. So I was very disturbed, I was troubled. So I remember I was given a separate table in the classroom.
Right.
I was like put in a corner, you know, away from the rest of the class.
Yeah. But before we get to anything, yours look like as we do.
You can dig in, please. Please help yourself.
To the king, but no, it's
please
fine.
Please help yourself.
I will just stick to my little basic chicken in
That's
the corner here, just for myself.
Yes, you know, even you have these, your skin will
glow.
Yes, you should.
Hello, my skin is anyway glowing. I don't need this.
All right. I'm not gonna say anything,
okay.
Danu.
This I always try to take the chopstick
no,
and look all fancy.
Bothered. I really can't be bothered.
I'm just an epic
putting
failure
myself through
this.
All that, Danu.
Yeah. For no reason.
I love Japanese, but I can never
go through this process.
Yeah, I know.
All right.
I'm just
so, and then it sort of, you decided, you know, it's time that I sort of give it a try and like bring out the best.
Yeah, so.
There you go. That's you.
I know.
And how did you end up in the industry where you are in right now?
Well, I never planned. Like I said, I was studious.
Yeah.
Like was always called the brain in the school. Mm. So I always wanted to pursue a career in law.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you would have done well.
Yeah, so I did 1 year of law college.
But it's a lot of memorizing to do. Yeah.
And then I was working for a...
You didn't want to do a private exam seated by yourself in a classroom?
No.
Just wanted to see. Okay.
So, yeah. And so what happened was... acting came to me as a surprise. I mean, never planned acting because my knowledge of Sri Lankan industry was probably Doodar when Nether. That's all you were allowed to watch back in the college.
Did you watch E.T. Pahan?
No.
That was also really nice.
Okay, so the two dramas I watched was Doodar and Nether.
Okay.
So that's all my
knowledge.
But you
were always on, like you used to do commercials and you were like in the zone.
No, not at the beginning.
Okay.
This was all started happening after once I got into modeling.
Right.
So modeling, actually, it was Roseanne Dias who pushed me. He was like, come. I was actually... I got selected for Etihad. I was waiting for my letter of appointment.
Right.
So it was during that I had a little break. It was then I bumped into Rosanna. She's like, oh, why not? Since you have a break, why don't you come and do a little bit of modeling for me?
Yeah.
Then I took over a bit of her time, whatever shows. And then one thing led to another. And then this, just like you said, I just walk into Maharaj to meet a friend of mine. And I got to the lift and I see this Indian director.
Mm-hmm.
And... of course, I smiled with them and I just
took off.
And then when I came down, the receptionist is like, hi, there is an audition happening in the first floor and they want you there for the audition. I said, what audition? I know nothing about acting. I'm like, sorry.
I'm just here.
And then...
why don't you eat? Because I feel bad for you.
That's fine. Thank you. And...
do you want some of your sauces?
Oh my God, now this is...
What in the world did you order?
I think two of us can have. I didn't know the portion was this
look
big.
At mine. I
honestly didn't know the portion was
you
this
have
big.
You have just ordered like a king and it's fine. Okay, so then that's how you got the role from
Danu,
the lift.
Wait. I need to look at my portion. This is like, how on earth I can have it for like 3 meals?
That's actually humongous.
Can we share it?
No, it's all for you. This is mine. Mine looks very pretty.
I didn't know the portions are like really big.
It is. Even this is really big. These are all sharing portions, which makes it a fun night out, actually.
We should have actually ordered just one.
Okay.
Danu.
Yeah.
I'm looking at this.
Go ahead.
It's so tempting.
Do you want to try it?
I actually don't mind.
Mm. Oh, wow.
It's nice.
That rice is so good.
Here, can we like share it?
Yeah, we can. You just want to be nice to me now. I'm not offering you, I'm sure you would have noticed that.
Okay, fine. You can go ahead. I'm not gonna have rice anyway.
Okay, so what's your meat diet like? I now know that you're
chicken.
Chicken
fish,
and
okay. Prawns. Cuttlefish. That's all.
So any meat is okay?
Any meat is alright.
This is the diet that you came up with?
Yes.
And it has worked well for you.
Mm-hmm.
Have you always been this size? Yeah.
I was never onto the fat size.
You are not, I'm sure. So anyway, it's fine.
Oh, this is yum.
It is. It just breaks off the bone, which means it's a good cut.
It just
good cut.
Melts in your mouth.
Brilliant.
It's
all right.
Yum.
While she enjoys that, let's get into a small break. We'll see you on
this
the other side.
Yum.
This is Done on Fire, right
I
here
think
on
Hi
TV.
Everyone here can just have a piece
of
this.
Yeah, I think we'll get the crew involved in this.
Exactly. This is so yum.
Welcome back to the show. We are after a heavy, heavy meal.
Yeah.
Are you recovering?
I'm stuffed. I'm having my green tea. I'm sipping my green tea now.
We actually ordered green tea because the food was so good. Yeah. Those were all sharing portions that you can actually enjoy at UH1. And the best part is they have been flown in. They're experts in what they do, all the way from China, making it authentic Chinese meal. That's what's great about it. When we are going out on a romantic date, would you bring me here, my dear?
Romantic?
Yes, romantic. Like the valet parking. Would you bring me here?
Yes, of course,
Thank
Danu.
Thank you. All right. So, we two single souls are doing this show. Yeah. Just subtly putting it there.
Subtly putting it there. Let's hope. Let's put the vibration out there. Hoping we'll attract.
That is true. Yeah.
Someone potential.
Yeah. So now, I'm sure there is that one thing that you like when one person cooks it for you. Do you have a person like that in your life?
Not really.
Not really, no?
No.
You know,
not at the moment.
Yeah. But there'll be one person who will cook it for you. Very
Hopefully
soon.
One day.
Yeah,
Fingers
very
crossed.
Soon. Very soon. Have you always planned of like, you know, having babies, settling down?
Babies, I'm away. Sorry for the confession.
Are you good with kids?
If I see cute babies, I would like cuddle them and play with them.
But you want to give...
But right now, I don't think I have that nurturing instinct to sort of have a one on my own.
Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah, there you go. All right, so I'm going to just give you a brief of what I'm having because I need to quickly come out of this topic. So I'm enjoying fried ice cream. And what are you having?
Mango salsa with deep fried ice cream.
No, that's what I'm having.
I don't know.
This is deep fried ice cream is with me. You are just having the mango salsa.
Whatever.
I can share one of the deep fried ice creams.
Yes. I could see that. Okay.
Have it.
All right, let's have it.
Yeah, yours look healthier though.
No.
Because
let's see.
I am quite fascinated. How do you fry? Oh, wow. Like, how do you fry ice cream? I need to come up with these things in
life. I'm going to dig into yours and see.
You can have a ball of your own.
No.
Oh, such a dirty girl, I tell you.
Danu, we are like, you know.
On screen,
we are on screen, yeah. We need to filter stuff.
So
you
comes,
and I?
She and I, we go to the same gym. You should see this one just working her soul out. Can I try some of your mango salsa?
Please do.
I know you don't have space anymore after... Eat with the ice cream.
Nice.
That's really nice.
Very nice.
All right. So, what's your feel-good moments in life? What do you do to, like, you know, pamper yourself a little bit? Are you a spa girl? Are you a shopping girl? Are you a...
I hate shopping.
Lone
I know.
Time?
I know. This is coming from an actress. I like shopping, but I don't like... spending hours and hours fitting on, trying
everything. So you are just a purpose outfit.
So when I walk, exactly. So when I walk in, you know I want exactly. to zoom in, zoom out. If I see something I like, I would try out. If not, I walk out.
Okay.
So I wouldn't like go try everything out. Okay, one now here, one now there. I hate that.
No. And also like, are you like, okay, you shop for a purpose. Okay, I have like an award ceremony today. I so need to look good.
Yeah.
Not
yeah.
the fact that, oh, I will buy
Let's
this.
Let's go shopping. And,
no,
unless you're overseas. Yeah, you do beat up. But still, I wouldn't like, you know, go spend hours, hours on and it. Hours.
No, okay. No, no, what do you think about crazy. The industry? How healthy is it today?
Let's not get there. Let's not get there. I want to commit suicide.
Do you find it very hard to...
maintain the status, obviously. Because clearly, because you could see... because social media has its own... pluses and minuses. Mm. Thanks to social media, we've been able to sort of take our work outside Sri Lanka.
And get the world to see a little
exactly.
bit.
Exactly. Yeah. But on the other hand, there are a lot of new faces who are walking. And by all means, we would welcome all the youngsters. We would want them to come.
You're not old, dear.
Yeah, I'm still 18.
Yeah. Well, you look it. If you were in India, you would have been still playing. I'm just going to school now.
Thank you, Rana. Yeah. But today, I just have a question mark. Like, when I joined the industry, it's solely because I had a passion for arts. Right, passion for acting.
Although the industry found you, you fell in love with the arts.
Absolutely fell in love with it. But today I have just to have a question mark whether people who want to, like people call themselves artists, but I wonder whether they have a passion, they have the love for arts, whether they have a love for what they do, for the industry, or is it just for the personal gains?
Yeah.
So it's sad, like when you hear things, lots of stories, it's out there, and the image they've created, it doesn't look really nice. It doesn't look pretty. It doesn't look good on the outer picture. So it saddens me because I love arts. Mm.
And you want it to be preserved so that it'll be a healthy industry always.
Exactly. And I would want people to come in and contribute as much as they get something from the industry. But I clearly don't see that anymore.
So for those who didn't know this pretty face, you would have at least got a little bit of an insight to who she is. Beyond the healthy food, beyond the glam that you see on her, she has a very deep story that makes her who she is. And also has the same emotions that we all go through,
exactly.
And that's what makes you human. Thank you for joining me on my, what can I say, another great meal experience. But Kingsbury Hotel, thank you so very much for hosting us once again, giving us this beautiful space and giving us a great place to enjoy a lovely meal. Urini, I wish you all the very best.
Thank you very much.
And
Dano.
I'm starting in the next music video, I've been told.
A belly dancer.
Yeah, just shaking. She wanted belly, I have a lot of it. We wrap things up on the show. Big shout out to LICC Jeans for joining us. And we will see you with another brilliant episode right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. Till I see you then, happy eating, keep smiling.